The difference between making one of our quest hoods as opposed to anyone else's Viking hood is we have a snack pocket. In this video, we're gonna make a quest hood out of a wool blanket. Coming up. Welcome to the Makers Movement. I'm Angel, and on this channel, we make all kinds of cool stuff. So if you're into cool stuff, hit that subscribe button. The first thing I'm going to do is lay out this blanket and cut my pieces. This hood is oversized. We like our hoods a little bit larger than what you can find online. We wear them everywhere. This is literally my winter coat all season. And we are going to cut three squares, 15 by 15, and one panel that is 15 by 16. The reason we're cutting three squares, 15 by 15, is here at Northwoods, we like to have a pocket in our quest hood because when you're questing, you get hungry and you need snacks. This blanket is 64 by 90. And you can get it on Amazon. I'll link to it in the description. You can get it in all kinds of colors, reds, blues, greens. There's a nice variety of color. And then you can mix and match like thread colors and really make something fun. Okay, this blanket from fold to edge is 31 inches and some change. So I need a panel that's 60. So I'm gonna keep it folded and I'm gonna go 15 in. And then 30 down. So I have 3 15 by 15 squares, 60 by 15. To make the pocket, I'm gonna take one square and we're gonna measure from 6 inches in on this and this, and then we'll do the opposite on this corner. Okay, we cut the pieces off the pocket and now we're going to add trim before we sew that this to any other panel. Trim I have is a double fold bias tape, large spool because we use a lot of it, but you can also get smaller packs with many different colors, which is always fun. These are the pieces we cut here, and we're gonna trim the sides. Go a little overhang, let's give it a cut. This is double fold, so you can see that there will be a nice edge. I'm gonna do a stitch here and also stitch here. So this is a modification that my son just did on his hood he made. And that's where we're folding over this piece. And I went about 2 inches in on each side. And then you won't have this point here. It will be a little more. Okay, so this is our 60-inch panel. Here's our pocket. This can get very confusing, this part. So that's what I'm gonna stitch. I'm gonna stitch this and this. So if you lay that out like that, you can fold that See, it's in there. Okay, so that side is stitched. Put my panel back together and line back up my corners. That looks correct. That folds in there, so remember. Okay, so now that's sewed and that's sewed. I'm going to flip it inside out. So that looks good. Flip it back inside out, and you're going to do the same thing with the last panel. So it's this line and this line. Okay, there's the last side that I need to stitch. This is the back of the hood, so we can actually run this stitch all the way up. So I've sewn on the last panel. This is the look that you want. And then we stitched up the back of the hood. And something that my kinsmen do here at Northwoods is we take the pointy hood and we curve it. So that way our quest hoods don't have this sharp pointy hood, because pointy hoods in Ostara is not a good look. Now that is a much better look.
You talking to me?
Nope. Nope. You can't be in this video. So everything is stitched together, but now I'm gonna go back and I'm gonna reinforce all my seams. I'm gonna do a zigzag stitch, because if you don't do a zigzag stitch and really reinforce it, the seams can pull out with excessive use. And that's something that I am should fix. This was my hunting hood, my hunting quest hood. So yeah, reinforce the seams. Okay, so there's our quest hood right side out. Now I'm going to take the double fold bias tape and I'm going to line the hood and the outside here. I'm gonna do it just like I did the pockets, but this time I'm gonna leave it attached to the spool so I don't cut it too short. Just one thing I want to note is the pocket, when I turned it right side out, it still has this ugly line. I did not turn it inside out like the hood. I stitch it and then turn it inside out, because we want it to lay really nice and flat, and that stitch, that ugly stitch, is going to be covered by trim. Okay, I'm almost around the whole hood, and now that I know I'm close, I can go ahead and cut my trim, because I know it's gonna fit. Okay, next thing on the hood is, it's time to put the little ties, and we put a leather disc there too. You don't need the leather disc. You don't need the leather ties, you can use shoestrings or 550 cord or anything.
strings.
Thanks, babes.
Yeah, sure.
Complete. Finished. Quest hood. It's nice and large. We got a really nice trim to it. Got a nice antler toggle. Thanks to my Goldie.
Huh?
Thanks for hanging out with me while I made this quest hood. If you want to see what a real quest looks like, here's one that Thor went on. I queued it up just for you. And may all your snack pockets be chock full of chocolate.